Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 10th March 2018. I am Sagar Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader at Superior Profit based in Singapore. I will not take time to introduce myself. If you are interested, you may visit the website superiorprofit.co, click on the About menu. To know more about me, the company Superior Profit, and more importantly, how it can help in your trading. Before we begin, we go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should only be used by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This session is not for any recommendation of buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decision made by its audience. As usual, we will look at key commodities, oil and gold, using technical charts. These tend to impact related stocks. If the broad market goes up, it tends to carry many stocks along with it. That's the reason we always keep an eye on the broad market. We'll study that using market break of NASDAQ and NYSE and also using the broad market ETFs technical charts. To add more edges to our trades, we may take long trades only in industries that are strong and short trades only in industries that are weak. That is very useful to increase success rate. We identify these higher probability trades using QEdge industry scorecard and heat map. From there, we can drill down to stocks fundamentals and finally look at their technical charts. Along the way, we may look at some of the trade ideas shared in our traders forum, and certainly, as always, look for potential trades for the coming week. That was the last slide of the presentation. We now move to live system. We start our commodity study using oil. We are looking at USO using weekly backdrop chart and daily hop-on chart. Together, we call this at-a-glance template because it helps us decide if there is a low-risk entry opportunity at the right edge of the chart in only few seconds. Last week, we discussed that oil was in narrow sideways range bound by resistance memory at the top and support memory at the bottom. That pattern is continuing. It couldn't break out of the triangle pattern in either direction. Therefore, we'll continue to observe US oil. There is no low risk entry opportunity right now. US oil doesn't have any clear direction. Let's see what is true for gold. We are now looking at gold using the same at a glance template. Gold is also moving down, up, down, up, down in a kind of triangle pattern bound by resistance memories at the top and watermark support lines at the bottom. Gold is also moving in narrow range. It doesn't have any clear direction, so we'll refrain from taking any trade in gold right now. Now we start with market breadth analysis. Every week we do this study using NASDAQ composite index and NYSE composite index using weekly charts. Because this analysis is using longer interval weekly charts and broad indices, this is to be used only for longer term trading decisions, not so much for swing trading and certainly not for day trading. Other than the indices, we also study three pairs of internals, new high low at the top, advanced decline in the middle, and up down volume at the bottom. Nasdaq went up strongly this week and broke above last all-time high, made a new all-time high with a very bullish shape candle, hollow long body, and also bullish color candle. NYSE also went up. The candle shape and color both are bullish, however the up move is much more muted. It couldn't even go above previous week's high, and it is far from all-time high. Over longer term, of course, both of them are in uptrend. Unless these memory support lines are broken, it will continue to be in uptrend. In terms of the internals, new high low, this is the internal that was driving market higher earlier. In last 2 weeks, this internal strength was weak, couldn't go up much. However, this week, at least for Nasdaq, that changed. New high low went up significantly. For NYSE, the new high low went up, but nowhere near as strong as Nasdaq. The other internals, advanced decline for both of the indices as well as up-down volume for both of the indices are quite strong. In summary, we can conclude that over longer term, the indices are clearly in uptrend and the internals are also strong this week. 5 of the 6 internals went up and all of them closed significantly above zero. This is a bullish picture. The only confusion is the huge divergence of strength between Nasdaq and NYSE. If you see in the earlier periods when Nasdaq was going up, NYSE was going up. Sometimes one was going up little bit stronger than another. However, this week the difference is very clear. For past several weeks, you can say past 3-4 weeks, the difference has been very prominent. This is confusing a little bit. Let's see if the broad market ETF study clarifies or adds to this confusion. We are looking at SPY using at a glance template. Weekly is clearly bullish, though it is very near or probably inside previous week's high. It couldn't surpass previous week's high. In daily chart, it broke out of the triangle pattern. However, it couldn't break out of the watermark resistance level in daily chart. It was moving inside triangle pattern. Now it broke out, but we are not fond of breakout trades because this kind of breakouts lead to very large stop loss. We are not happy to take such large stop loss trades. We might wait for it to pull back and then go up again, thereby giving us a higher low and a low risk long entry opportunity. Right now there is no trade in SPY. QQQ, in the weekly chart we can see clearly that it broke above the watermark resistance and made another new all-time high. It flipped from bearish magenta color to bullish cyan color in the weekly chart. Didn't go through the yellow neutral color. That means it went up strongly and suddenly. In the daily chart on this candle, this Monday, QQQ gave a go with flow long trade setup. Entry would be just at the close of that day. Stop would be just below recent low, which was also below the support level of the yellow direction line. One could book partial profit once risk resistance was covered or at the upper boundary. By Friday, the upper boundary was almost hit. One could book at least partial profit. Because QQQ is strong both in weekly and daily charts, and it is the strongest of the four broad market ETFs, one might not need to close entire position. Partial swing trade position may be held to try to let profit run. At the right edge, QQQ is already up significantly, so we are not going to take any long trade right now. The optimal entry point was at Monday's close. QQQ is the strongest of the four ETFs and DIA is the weakest. This is Dow Jones Industrial Average. In the weekly chart, again it is bullish in terms of shape and color. However, it is significantly below previous week's high and certainly below all-time high. Remember, in last week's market roundup, we discussed that all the broad market ETFs were in narrow patterns, range-bound patterns, triangle patterns, somewhat wide. All the ETFs could break out of that except DIA. DIA is remaining inside the triangle pattern. No breakout has taken place. Clearly, there is no trade opportunity right now in DIA. IWM was actually the second strongest ETF. We are looking at IWM using at a glance template again. Here, the weekly is bullish in shape and color. Follow long body is bullish, sand color is bullish, and it closed comfortably above previous week's high. Very near to previous all-time high. On last Friday, it had a very strong bullish shape and color candle. However, at that time, it was just inside the triangle pattern. This is what we discussed in last market roundup. So we would not be taking any swing long trade at that point. It broke out of the triangle pattern on Tuesday and continued to go upward. Very close to upper boundary, already significantly above the recent low. So we are not going to take any swing long trade right now. The broad market indices showed considerable divergence of strength between Nasdaq and NYSE. The same picture is present when we study broad market ETFs. QQQ is much stronger than SPY. Russell 2000 ETF is strong as well, and DIA is the weakest. So there is a mixed picture. This is not a very confidently bullish market, not bearish market also. This may be a time to be cautious and not have too many positions in either direction. At the same time, using Q 360 degrees analysis, we can always identify long and short trade opportunities, studying the industries and drilling down to stocks. Let's do that now. Every week, we study 11 sectors across 3 review periods. Red bar represents performance of this week, green bar performance of 1 week prior to the red bar, and blue bar performance of 2 weeks prior to the green bar. Together they constitute 4 weeks or about 1 month of performance. Any bar coming to the right of the zero line shows the sector went up, and any bar going to the left of the zero line shows the sector went down. What does this graph show us this week? All the 11 sectors went up this week. We know that because all the red bars are to the right of the zero line. What happened 1 week ago? All the green bars came to the left of the zero line, showing that all the sectors were down 1 week ago, and in this week all the sectors are up. In fact, out of the past 7 weeks, 6 weeks have seen either all sectors up or all sectors down. Down weeks have seen higher activity. This flip-flop is probably a sign of caution to not load up on positions in either direction. The conclusion that we were arriving at from broad market and ETF study seems to hold true from sector flip-flop study as well. Interestingly, this week, industrials as a sector is the best performer. The red line is the strongest, went up by more than 4%, went up even more than information technology. Information technology had been strong for many periods. Though the industrials as a sector is the strongest, again, confusingly, DIA is the worst performer among the broad market ETFs. Such conflicting signals mean that the market's direction is not fairly apparent. Maybe again a valid reason to stay away from the market. Not completely out of the market. We can always find some trading opportunities from the top-down or bottom-up approach, as we will do right now. Here is a chart I made of the flip-flops. This is a chart of SPY, weekly chart. When the market was going up in this period, it was not common to see all the sectors going up or all the sectors going down together, let alone flip-flop as it is apparent now. This was the week when I discussed in the weekly market roundup that all the sectors went up. That was accompanied by heavy activity. That was the time that we had bearish headwind in QQQ, DIA as well as SPY. I could make significant profit by closing all my long positions between these 3 weeks. This week and this week, and moving to short positions. Now this week all sectors went up. This week all sectors went down. This week again all sectors went down. At the end of this week in the market roundup, we discussed that there were bounce long trade setups in multiple broad market ETFs. So I closed all my short positions and took some long position using SPY call option. Next week, all the sectors went up again. This is one week where sectors were mixed. Some sectors went up, some went down. 1 week ago, all sectors went down, and this week, all sectors went up. 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 So, 3 of the 7 weeks, all sectors went up. This is showing massive flip-flop among the sectors. That is also a reason to be cautious. I spent long time making this chart. Sometimes charts illustrate a point better than my words. It was fun making this. Okay. So sector level we have flip-flop. Industry level we can always find trading opportunities. We are studying the best performing industries of this week. Of the 10 best performing industries, all but one were down in the previous week, further illustrating the market's indecision. The best performing industries are distributed among diverse sectors. No particular sector is stronger than others. I mentioned we can always find profitable trade opportunities using Q 360 degrees analysis. We had some of those opportunities in the long direction in semiconductor equipment. This is the only industry that continued its upward momentum from the previous week among the 10 best performing industries. This stock, Lam Research, LRCX, and Rudolph Technologies, RTEC. They are both near 52-week high. However, it is essential to make a distinction between stocks near 52-week high and stocks that are fundamentally good value stocks. Though these two stocks are at 52-week high, they still have good fundamental valuation. How we know that? We know that from the Q Vital statistics. Their valuation score is in cyan color because they are still optimally valued. Even though they are at 52-week high, we'll be happy to take a long trade if a chart trade setup appeared. Both of them gave go with flow long signals this week. Both the trades turned out to be very profitable. They don't only have optimal valuation, but they have high growth as well. We don't find such nice opportunities every day, but when they come, we confidently take those trades, making sure that the risk is always small. That is a constant in all our trade setups. And that was true for Lam Research and Rudolph Technologies as well. Let's use QEdge now, study the best performing industries there, drill down into semiconductor equipment stocks, identify these two stocks, fundamentals, and then look at their technical charts to see how we could easily identify and then take the trades. Every time we open QEdge, it analyzes 11 sectors and more than 170 industries across 12 monthly review periods, and more frequently over recent periods, 10 days, 5 days, 2 days, and 1 day. 5-day period is colored in a different shade because this is the primary period that we use to decide our trade entry, both for swing trade as well as long-term investment. Let's go to the sector panel. For every review period, Edge assigns a score, 1 to the worst performer, plot number to the best performer, and also applies a heat map, magenta to the weakest one, cyan to the strongest one. In all Q tools, magenta red indicates bearish or weak, cyan or green indicates bullish or strong, yellow indicates neutral. The result is a scorecard and heat map table that instantly tells us which sector is weak now. Utilities is weak. Which one is strong? Industrials. This was the dilemma I was sharing earlier. DIA, DIA ETF, is the weakest of the four ETFs. DIA is supposed to be based on industrial stocks. However, the industrials as a sector is strongest. We also see utilities is weak for long time. In fact, that is the time that we start looking for long opportunities. Same may be true for consumer staples. Consumer discretionary was strong earlier, now weakening. We started seeing this weakness in the previous market roundup. Many of the consumer discretionary industries were among the worst performers. We'll see if that is true in this week's analysis as well. The analysis that is done for 11 sectors is done for the 170 plus industries. To find the strongest industries, we sort over the primary 5 days period, largest to smallest. Semiconductor equipment is an industry that was strong for long time and remaining strong. We can click the drill down button to get the stocks. QEdge goes to Thomson Reuters icon, that is Metastock Zenith, to retrieve the stocks. It has found the stocks. We can click the calculator button to retrieve data on all of these stocks and calculate vital statistics. The calculation is complete. We can go to the scorecard tab, refresh the data, and look for the optimal valuation stocks. We can do that by sorting the stocks on relative valuation column, largest to smallest. Any stock that has good valuation comes in cyan color. We don't need to even look at the scores, just cyan color indicates it is strong. RTEC and LRCX, Rudolph and Lamb Research, both has optimal valuation. Both has strong earnings quality as well, shown by cyan color in the earnings quality column. They have short squeeze potential as well, meaning that these stocks have significant short holdings, though the stocks are near 52 week high. If the stocks started to go up, then shorts might start to cover, that would further fuel the rally. So these indicators were all good for taking a long trade setup. We had to wait for the long trade setup to come on the Q charts. Let's have a look at the charts now for RTEC and LRCX. We are looking at RTEC using at a glance template, Rudolph Technologies. In the weekly chart, it made a new all-time high. On Tuesday, it gave a go with flow long trade setup. We know that because the stock was moving in uptrend and the cyan color candle indicates the optimal long trade opportunity. We could take the long at the close of that day's bar, stop just below recent low, booking profit at the upper counter, which was hit on Thursday. The stocks is very strong fundamentally and very strong technically as well. Therefore, using Q guideline, there is no reason to exit full position. We might book profit on partial position and use Q protection signal to protect profit on the remaining position. Let's see where the stop loss will be as of Friday's close, or rather where the protect profit stop would be as of Friday's close, that is trailing stop. As the stock went up, these magenta dots also went up, and as of Friday's close, the trailing stop could be set at this level, that is 28.45. That is very close to the initial profit target. So even if the stock were to reverse and hit the trailing stop, we'll still have large profit on the remaining position as well. This trailing stop works pretty well in protecting profit and trying to let profit run. Let's look at Lamb Research. Lamb Research chart is very similar to Rudolph Technologies. It also broke out of the previous all-time high in the weekly chart. In daily chart, here on Monday, it gave a go with flow long trade setup that hit profit target by this week. Again, the stock is very strong fundamentally and also very strong technically. There would not be any reason to exit full position. Partial position may be held using Q protection signal for trailing stop. There is a question on DQ. The DQ is also fundamentally optimally valued. Let's have a look at its technical charts. In the weekly chart, DQ candle color is bearish. In fact, it displayed a bearish headwind signal at the very top, both in weekly chart as well as daily chart. Sometimes it works like a miracle. I also don't know exactly how the mathematical calculation is able to catch the very top so precisely. Using the bearish headwind signals in daily and weekly, one would at least protect profit in existing long positions. Then we could take bearish short trade using this magenta color candle. At the right edge, it is bearish. Just by looking at the color, we know it is bearish. There is no long trade setup, and we were only going to take long trades in this industry because the industry is strong. That is the key 360 degrees way. We want to align all the forces in our trade's favor. That is not aligned in this case for DQ. Industry is strong, but the stock's technical charts is not strong. So we are not going to take any long trade. We looked at semiconductor equipment and we saw that in spite of somewhat confusing signal at the broad market level and even at sector level, we can always find trade opportunities at industry and stocks level. That is what I always tend to say, broad market is too broad and even sectors are too broad to try to align forces in our trade's favor. At industry level, stocks tend to move much more homogeneously. That is from where top-down analysis can begin. We don't really need to start from sector level. In fact, if we start from sector level or from broad market level, we will miss out on many opportunities because sector and market levels does a lot of aggregation. We are not able to unearth the proper movement of the industries and stock. One more interesting stock in the best performing list is agriculture and farm machinery. We'll come back to that when we study the accelerating industries. We are looking at the worst performing industries now. In the previous week, six of the worst performing industries were in consumer discretionary sector. We discussed that in last market roundup. The recording is in YouTube channel. The same is true for this week as well. These lists from previous week and this week show a continuation of weakness in the sector. The QH heat map is also clearly showing the weakness. So from previous week itself, we were starting to be cautious on long positions in consumer discretionary sector and specifically in these industries. In department stores, we can see the heat map nicely changing color from cyan to magenta, strength to weakness. In this industry, JCPenney, JCP, gave a profitable box short trade setup on 1st March. You could precisely enter that at pre-existing watermark level using Q fine-tune chart. I have discussed this technique earlier in many market roundups. When we have a pre-existing support or resistance level, in this case resistance level, price comes there and starts to reverse. Then we can switch from daily chart to real-time 5-minute or 10-minute chart, Q fine-tune template, and precisely enter the trade, as we could do again for JCPenney. Let's start with QH, see the weakness of the sector, consumer discretionary sector, weakness of department stores, and then go to the technical charts of JCPenney. Consumer discretionary as a sector, we can see from the heat map it was strong earlier, now turning weak, magenta. However, the sector is too broad to decide on a particular stock trade. We can drill down into the underlying industries by clicking the drill down button. Now it is showing only the consumer discretionary industries. Let's sort over 5 days, smallest to largest. That will bring the weakest industries to the top. Department stores immediately catches the eye. It was pretty strong earlier over many months. Now turned from score 140 to 45 between month 1 and 10 days period. Over 5 days, it reduced further to a score of 4. Over 5 days, it is also decelerating. Deceleration is something that shows up in the pace column. 5 days is the primary period. So this industry was strong earlier, weakened, and weakened very fast with deceleration. We could click the drill down button again to get the stocks. We have multiple stocks. Calculating the vital statistics, we can do that using the calculator button. It is retrieving the data from Thomson Reuters icon. Now in terms of fundamentals, JCPenney is actually optimally valued, but it doesn't have good growth. Especially revenue growth is negative. We know that from the background shades of the revenue growth columns. Over 1 year period and 2 year periods, revenue growth is negative. Earnings quality is also poor. Magenta always represents weakness. Valuation wise, it is strong. Let's look at JCPenney's chart. It dropped significantly from its strength. That's why it is possible that it was optimally valued. Let's change the template, daily template, to clean chart template. We can use the clean chart template to identify the bounce and box trade setups. We don't need to use the template with all the signals. In the weekly chart, we see JCPenney dropped significantly. That's why at the bottom, it is at optimal valuation. However, looking at recent weeks, it turned magenta. That is bearish. And it created a false upside breakout on this candle when price tried to go above the watermark resistance but reversed. In daily chart, the same false breakout showed up at this point. This candle was still green, so we were not going to take any short trade at the close of that candle. Next candle closed above the watermark resistance, so we were not going to take any short trade on that candle either. Next day, price opened above the watermark resistance, but it started to go down. We could at that time switch to fine-tune chart and take a short precisely at this price level, putting stop on real-time fine-tune chart just above that day's high. Let's draw the line, switch to fine-tune chart, and see how precisely we could enter the trade with very low risk and then profit from the trade. I see there was earnings nearby. If there is earnings nearby for swing trading, we don't like to trade using stocks. That is too much risk. However, options can be traded. Because options volatility is high, it would not be efficient to trade simple put options. But short call vertical is probably the most appropriate setup, which will benefit from the delta move of the stock downward and also the volatility crash that will happen after earnings is out. This turned out to be a very profitable trade entered using fine-tune chart. Let's see how we could do that. In the daily chart, we already knew the level of the watermark resistance. On this candle, when price opened above that and started to go down, we could draw the horizontal line at the watermark level and switch to fine-tune real-time chart. Let me also draw a vertical line so that I can identify the exact date on fine-tune chart. We are now looking at JCPenney using 10-minute fine-tune template. This is the day where price opened above the watermark resistance level and started to go down. Soon after market open, early range high and early range low lines form the pivot levels. We will take a short using early range breakout technique at the close of this candle, which closed below the early range low. Though we were entering the trade in 10-minute fine-tune chart, the trade was supposed to be swing trade. On the entry day, our stop loss will be just above recent high, that is day's high. Our risk amount will be this much on 10-minute time interval. But remember, this is supposed to be a swing trade where our profit target would be over daily chart interval. When these trades are not stopped out, like was true in this case, they give huge reward risk ratio. On the same day, price continued to go down. Next day it opened lower, tried to go up. Few days it moved sideways and then it moved down again. Let's go back to the daily chart. We could enter the trade at this price level, stop just above that day's high. And since then, price has moved significantly lower, giving a very large reward risk ratio. Because the stock is continuing to be bearish with red color, we may exit partial position, but partial position may be held. I see that it came to watermark support, tried to go down and reversed. So we'll be cautious. It may go up now. We don't need to exit the remaining position, but we can use the trailing stop. Where will the trailing stop be? Currently, the trailing stop will be at this level. Our trade was entered at this level. Even if the stock hits the trailing stop, we'll have significant profit on the remaining position. Back to us performing industries, we could identify and take a precise short trade in JCPenney. Another industry that is turning into weakness from strength is apparel retail. In this industry, I found BKE, Buckle. It has poor fundamental growth. It's one of the worst growth companies in this industry. It gave a box short trade setup on 27th Feb. Children's Palace, another stock, PLCE, is medium value, that is yellow color in scorecard, relative valuation score. It declined after displaying bearish headwind at the very top on 23rd Jan. When the bearish headwind came, we would be cautious about long positions, protect our profit. After that it declined, probably we had some profitable short trade opportunities as well. Yes, it could be shorted using go with flow short signal on 30th Jan. In fact, that was the first possible trend following swing short trade. Another stock, American Eagle Outfitters, AEO, is also medium value. It had displayed bearish headwind in both weekly and daily charts right before it dropped heavily on earnings this week on 8th March. That was Thursday. Because bearish headwinds have appeared, you may protect profit if you are holding long position using Q protection signal trailing stop, and also look for potential short. Let's look at apparel retail, one of the worst performing industries, using QH. See how it is transitioning from strength to weakness. Drill down, find these three stocks, BKE, PLCE and AEO, and look at them using Q charts. For finding the worst performing industries, we can sort over primary 5 days period, smallest to largest. Apparel retail is one of the weakest. It was cyan, stronger earlier, now weakened, and it also weakened with deceleration, that is weakened fast. We know that from the magenta color over pace, 5 days color. We can drill down to the stocks of apparel retail. 25 stocks found. Clicking the calculator will retrieve detailed data and calculate vital statistics. It's retrieving data now. Let's go to scorecard, refresh the data, look for the weak stocks. Okay, BKE is actually optimally valued, but it has one of the worst growths. So a stock can be weak either in terms of valuation or growth. Either way, it is fine. We can look for short trade here. So BKE had one of the worst growths. Children's Place is medium valuation, and so is AEO, American Eagle Outfitters. Let's look at these charts. We can use this advanced hop-on template that we are using now. It has few more signals than are required to check the unambiguous checklist. That is fine. This is BKE buckle using at a glance template. In the weekly chart, it is magenta for 2 weeks now. At this time, it came to the watermark resistance and reversed from there. Earlier, it had high activity at the same price level, showing possible exhaustion. That met all the requirements of a box short trade setup on this magenta candle. And remember just now what we discussed. Because we knew about the watermark resistance level, if we were using real-time chart and we saw price trying to go up and then reversing, we could take a short trade right at this price level. For that day, the stop will be just above recent high. By the end of that day, much more than the risk distance was covered. So it was again a swing short trade setup that could be entered precisely using fine-tuned chart. We didn't have to wait for the end of the day. At the end of the day also, we could take the short trade, and by this Friday, in either case, we covered much more than the risk distance. This short trade we could take in an industry that was weakening, in a stock with very poor growth. And technically, it had a sideways market box short trade set. What about the other two stocks? One was PLCE, Children's Place. Displayed a bearish headwind at the very top. Since then, it started to go down. Looking at the bearish headwind signal, we would protect profit using Q protection signal, trailing stop. Then on this magenta candle, we could take a go with flow short trade. Except that I see there was a memory support at that time. So you would not enter trade on the close of this bar. Instead, wait for next day, and as price opened, started to go down, using fine-tuned chart, early range breakout technique, we would be able to take the short at the upper end of this red candle. Stop would be just above recent high, entry would be somewhere near this price range. This would be the risk. By the day price came here, we had much more than risk distance covered, so we will be booking profit. At the right edge, there is no short trade setup in this stock. It has already declined somewhat from the recent high. So we are not going to take any short trade here now. We could protect profit in long positions using the bearish headwind signal alert and then take a short trade based on the signal of this magenta day. The third stock was AEO. Very nice chart, immediately catches the eye. In the weekly chart, it had a long-term watermark resistance coming from far away. 2 weeks ago, price went above that with heavy activity. Not very heavy activity on weekly charts. And this week, it reversed. It had a bearish headwind signal in the weekly chart. It reversed with very high activity as well. However, the week ended just above the watermark resistance with a long lower tail, so the candle shape is mixed. It has solid body that is bearish but long lower tail that is bullish, so the shape is indecisive. And also it closed just above the watermark level. So we were not going to take any short trade on Friday's close. In daily chart, we see that it tried to go above this watermark level and reversed with this large candle, bearish candle. On Friday, it went up little bit. The industry is weakening, the stock is at very high level, and the chart is starting to look bearish. So if it goes up little bit and tilts down, then it will give our first go with flow short trade opportunity. Or if price goes to the watermark resistance, reverses from there, it will give a box short trade opportunity. We already have extreme high activity at this price level that shows possible exhaustion. So if price comes to this level and reverses, we'll meet all the conditions of box short trade setup in daily chart. You may keep an eye on that. This is not a stock we would like to take long position. Now, the industry is weakening, the chart is also weakening. We have bearish color in both daily and weekly charts. We may look for potential shorts instead. Steel is another industry that was strong for a long time. US government imposed tariff on steel imports. However, much before the news was out, the industry was already strengthening. In Q trading, we like to follow the data based on industry analysis, fundamental and technical charts. We don't wait for the news to be out. In fact, after the news was out, steel industry decelerated. Whatever is coming in news media is different. We rely on the actual data that shows the steel industry decelerated, and US Steel was about to give a short trade setup on Friday. I was watching the stock. It came up on Q sonar, that is the bottom up way of finding trade opportunities. At that time I shared the trade in our forum. Possible trade setup. For swing trade setup, we need to wait for the day's close to confirm. We can take the trade just before market close. That is my preferred time to take the trade. This is the setup that I shared. Let's have a look at that. I identified it using Q Elite's sonar dashboard. It could be identified using Q Global's sonar explorer as well. On that day, many of the stocks were bullish. This was one of the rare stocks that came up in the sonar with a bearish setup. X is US Steel with a possible void flow trend following short trade setup. And it is showing it opened the day with a 3.1% gap up. And since open, it declined. As of the time, the snapshot was taken by 7.2%. So on a closing basis, it was already down by 4.1%. So the stock was starting to go up but reverse. That is a false upside breakout. I looked up the steel industry at that time and it was clearly bullish earlier, cyan color in the heat map and turning magenta, weak in recent periods in score, and also turning into weakness fast with acceleration, or you can say deceleration, that showed up as magenta color on the past 5 days. So the stock could give me a short trade setup. The industry was weak. I looked at the stock's fundamentals. It was not optimally valued anymore, not overvalued also. It's yellow in the medium. EPS growth over 1 year was negative. In terms of growth, it was not strong. I see other stocks had much better growth. It was positive and also in cyan color, NEV for example. So we could look for a short trade in X based on industry's weakness, poor growth, and the signal from the sonar. At the time I shared the chart, it looked very bearish, isn't it? In the weekly, at the very top, again, it displayed a bearish headwind. Last time it displayed a bearish headwind in the weekly chart, it resulted in a significant drop. Last time was also a case of false upside breakout. This time it is very close to the long-term watermark resistance. If it goes down little bit, it will create a powerful false upside breakout accompanied by bearish headwind. In the daily chart, it went up strongly here. In fact, on this cyan color candle, we could take a go with flow long trade. Stop just below recent low. Entry at this price level, profit would be taken at the upper bounded. Remember, at this time, probably the industry was strong. Then it was moving sideways. When I shared the chart, it dropped sharply and closed below the memory support level. Not close, but as of that time, it was below the memory support level. So it looked bearish. We needed to wait for the day's end around 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to confirm the signal. In fact, the signal was not confirmed because the candle ended up with a long lower tail. Let's look at the chart now. On Friday, price recovered, closed just below the memory support. That's why the memory support is now in dotted line. It is broken, but it recovered significantly. Whenever there is a long lower tail, we are not going to enter the trade immediately on that day. We may wait for next day and use real-time fine-tune chart to see if there is a low risk entry opportunity. Another reason I was not going to take the short trade on Friday's close is that the weekly candle turned yellow, neutral. When I shared the chart in the forum, the weekly candle was magenta. So it was meeting all the requirements, the unambiguous checklist requirements of go with flow short trade setup. You can see it was starting to topple over. So it was possible to apply the go with flow short trade setup. But at the end of the day, it had a long lower tail in daily chart and the weekly turned yellow. So I was not going to take a short trade anymore. However, it is looking bearish, not bullish anymore. Okay, except the long lower tail on Friday. If it continues to go down next week, and if the industry also continues to be weak, then we may have an opportunity to short a stock at the very top. Another option could be to wait for the stock to go down, come back up and go down again, giving us a clear go with flow short trade setup with lower highs and lower lows. Both are possible. Because we are combining the industry's weakness and fundamental weakness with the chart's signal, it is possible to take a short at the very top. Also, I tend to put weightage on the bearish headwind signals that has come in the weekly chart. It is certainly not a time to take a long trade in USD. Every week we study the accelerating industries because they tend to be some of the best performers in subsequent weeks. We have three industries related to construction and machinery in the list of accelerating industries, the 10 best accelerating industries. They are construction, machinery and heavy trucks, agricultural and farm machinery and machinery. When similar industries strengthen together, then it is more convincingly strong and it is easier to take a long trade in those industries. Construction, machinery and heavy trucks has this stock ALSN Transmission, ALSN, that is very interesting. Has strong relative as well as internal value, has strong earnings quality, EPS and revenue growth increased in recent periods, and it completed a false downside breakout after displaying a bullish headwind in daily and now resting on support direction line, giving a possible buy opportunity as of Friday's close. We'll look at that ALSN. The another industry that is of interest is agricultural and farm machinery. We have this very well-known stock here, dear, I don't know how you pronounce it, Deere and Co. DE. This industry was strong earlier, weakened briefly in the middle and accelerated again this week. When that kind of movement happened, it can give us a swing low and allow us to take a low risk entry. Deer and Co. has the best internal score and best dividend yield among peers. Not very high dividend, but among peers it is the best dividend paying stock. Relative valuation score is medium. It gave a box long trade setup on this Monday and a possible go through long trade setup on Thursday. I think both of those trades are doing well. Let's look at the accelerating industries in QH. Go to the construction machinery, heavy trucks, and agricultural farm machinery industries and look at these stocks. ALSN Transmission and Dairy and Co. In QH, to look for the accelerating industries, we sort over the past 5 days column, largest to smallest. See, construction, machinery and heavy trucks was strong earlier, dipped in the middle, becoming magenta, and now turned cyan over 5 days period. So it is already bullish and it turned cyan in score with acceleration, with force. Same is true for agricultural, farm and machinery. Was strong earlier, weakened in the middle, now bullish and bullish with acceleration. In the at a glance template, at this level, it created a double top in weekly chart. It dropped significantly, now came to a watermark support level from the past. This was an area of congestion. Those are exit points, not entry points. And price came to that level and reversed this week. Displayed a bull release signal in the weekly chart. Weekly candle color turned neutral. In the daily chart, after displaying bearish headwind, which would have alerted us to protect profit in long positions, it declined. We could take go with flow trend following short trades at these magenta color candles. Then it dropped at the right edge. That is where we need to decide for our next entry. We see it displayed a bull headwind signal. Bullish headwind signal went below the long-term watermark support level and reversed. On Friday, it closed above the watermark support, creating a false downside breakout, and it also closed just above, nicely above the white direction line. Very long-term support level. Candle color turned cyan. Because in daily it dropped significantly, the weekly didn't turn into cyan yet. So this is not a perfect void flow long trade setup. However, there are probably enough signs allowing us to take a long trade. First, it came to a weekly watermark support, created a false downside breakout. Daily also, it created a false downside breakout. It has a bullish headwind signal, a cyan color candle, and the stop is pretty narrow. This is in auto and truck industry. Okay, let's go back to the Q Vital. Okay, we have ALSN.K in construction, machinery, and heavy trucks. By clicking the calculator button in Q Vital, we'll retrieve data on all these stocks and calculate vital statistics. The calculation is complete. Instantly from color coding, we can see ALSN.K is optimally valued, both for relative valuation and internal valuation. Growth over 1 year is one of the strongest. Has good earnings quality, showing in cyan color. If we go to the growth panel, we can see for ALSN Transmission, recent quarter over quarter growth is very nice. Shown in green color, bright green color. So we have nice growth, we have optimal valuation and good earnings quality in a stock that nicely created a false downside breakout after displaying bullish headwind, went back above the white direction line. This is probably a very nice trade setup you may consider. Let's look at the other stock, Dairy and Co. In the daily chart, it came to this watermark support level. There was exhaustion, very high activity on this down bar, and next day it went back up. that met all the conditions of a box long trade setup on this yellow candle. Entry would be just at that day's close, stop just below recent low. Partial profit could be booked once the risk distance was covered, which happened by Friday. Because the daily candle chart is very bullish, color is also bullish, weekly is also bullish, the industry is accelerating, it would not be required to exit full position. Partial position may be held. Easy trades that we could identify using top-down analysis or bottom-up analysis, both for ALSN transmission as well as DE, as we could do for Lam Research, as we could do for the other semiconductor stock as well. Decelerating industries, so we keep an eye on them, looking for potential shorts. However, they may be used also for another purpose. Sometimes, if the industry is weak for a long time, then started to go up and now decelerated again, it is possible that it will turn up again because it was already weak for a long time. We may see if some of the stocks in these industries belong to that category. We had discussed few of these stocks earlier, AES.N in independent power and renewable electricity producers, ADM, I think Archer 10 years, in agricultural products, it's going up after a false downside breakout, and TDS, telephone and data systems. All of these we discussed in earlier market roundups, looking for potential longs. Though these industries are decelerating this week, these three stocks that we discussed earlier are nicely holding on to their values. Let's have a look at them using QVITAL and then look at their charts. Before looking at QVITAL, let us look at them on QEDGE also. To identify the decelerating stocks, we refresh QEDGE and sort it over past 5 days, smallest to largest. Wireless telecom services. I think TDS belongs to this industry, was weak earlier, strengthened, now weakened with deceleration. Same is true for independent power and renewable energy producers. Tried to go up and weakened again. And agricultural products. Tried to go up a little bit and declined again. So we had discussed three stocks in these three industries earlier when they were about to strengthen. TDS in wireless telecom, AES in independent power and renewable energy producers, and ADM in agricultural products. Let's look at their charts. We are looking at ADM, Archer Daniels Midland, using at a glance template. We started discussing the stock when it completed a false downside breakout here and again here. There was a memory resistance in weekly. We could still take a long trade using daily chart probably and make some profit. This week it broke above the memory resistance. So it broke above the triangle pattern in weekly charts. Because it was in triangle pattern in weekly, in daily it was moving down, up, down, up, down, up. If somebody was tracking ADM regularly, he might be able to take a long trade on this long cyan bullish candle. At that time, it closed above all the four direction lines. This doesn't happen often. For going through long trade setup, our only requirement is price should go above the magenta and cyan direction lines. Sometimes we have three directions coming together. In this case, which is pretty rare, all the four direction lines came together and price closed above all of them. In a way, you can say traders of different intervals, short term, long term, medium, very long, everybody was going to take long because price was closing above the direction lines. So a long could be taken at the close of this candle, of course, based on the industry strength also. And because it was in sideways range, profit could be booked, at least partial profit, at the watermark resistance level. Stop would be here. It already gave nice reward risk ratio of about 1. That is fine for our swing trades. Because the industry is decelerating, I will always book some profit in this case. Maybe book whole profit because the industry decelerated. If the stock goes down and goes up again, it will give us a proper go with flow long trade opportunity. How about ADM's fundamentals? Q Vital can be used to analyze stocks in any country. QAGE USA is meant for USA market, where we have significant data to calculate the sector and industry scorecards. But Q Vital is for global stocks. It has retrieved 10 stocks, peers of Archer Daniels Midland. You can click the calculator button to calculate Vital statistics. If you watch the earlier market roundups, you would know that when we identified these opportunities, ADM, AES and TDS, all were strong in terms of fundamentals, in terms of technicals, as well as in terms of industry. ADM, we can see, is still optimally valued, pays the best dividend among the peer stocks. So it was optimally valued when we identified earlier, it is still optimally valued. So we could continue to look for long trade setup in this stock. TDS, this is a stock in the wireless industry that we saw decelerated. However, we discussed this long time ago when in the weekly chart, it created a false downside breakout. In the daily chart, it happened around this time. We could take a long trade on this very strongly bullish candle. It went up from there. Last week in the roundup, I mentioned that it was very bullish in terms of shape and color in the weekly chart. But I said also that because of the memory resistance in weekly, will be cautious. There was no need to exit the remaining position. We could use Q protection signal in daily chart. And though the industry decelerated, our remaining long position is holding on nicely to its price. If it hits the trailing stop, that is fine. We would still be far away with good profit on the remaining position. Partial position we would have booked already. This shows that if we identify a trade combining all the forces, even some temporary pullback in the overall industry or deceleration in the industry, may not easily result in stopping out our position, as we see in case of TDS, as we saw in case of ADM also. Let's look at the utility stock we identified earlier, AES. I think this was also optimally valued when we identified it. It also had a very nice false downside breakout, which was accompanied by very high activity in the weekly chart. Price tried to go below the watermark in daily also and reverse. On this cyan color candle, we could take a long trade. Because earnings was nearby, we were probably going to consider trade with short put verticals. Or if it was a longer term investment, we could take it before earnings as well. Though the industry decelerated, AES is nicely holding on to its value, declined little bit. Now if it goes up and gives a cyan color candle, it will give us the next go with flow long trade setup. Weekly is already cyan, so that will meet all the requirements for go with flow long trade setup. Let's summarize the broad market internals show that Nasdaq is much stronger, making a new all-time high. NYSE is far from that. The same is shown from the broad market ETFs. QQQ is strongest, followed by IWM, Russell 2000, followed by SPY, and DIA is the worst performer. DIA is the only one that could not break outside the triangle pattern that we observed in many of the ETFs 1 week ago. It is common that one of the indices, Nasdaq, NYSE, one is stronger than other, but right now the strength of Nasdaq is much more than NYSE, and Nasdaq is at all-time high. This may not be a time to take many long trades because many of the stocks will be overvalued. However, we also saw that at 52-week high or all-time high doesn't necessarily mean that a stock is overvalued. We saw that into semiconductor industry stocks, which were at 52-week high, but they are still at optimal valuation based on Q Vital statistics, and both of them gave very profitable go with flow long trade setups. In terms of sector, we are seeing massive flip-flop in last 7 weeks, 6 of the weeks. It either went up all sectors or went down all sectors. Actually, 3 weeks went up all sectors, 3 weeks went down all sectors, 1 week was mixed. This kind of massive flip-flop is not common, and that the market is at or near all-time high is showing that probably it is good to be careful. We can take trades but not load up on too many trades in one direction, neither long side nor short side. However, the weekly flip-flops are fine to take swing trades because each of those flip-flops will probably give us low risk entry opportunities, maybe box, maybe bounce or headwind or even go with flow. We can take swing trades. It may be a good idea to have some long sides, some short sides, so that when the market direction is clearer, we can hold on to the positions following the direction of the market and exit the others using stop loss. There are always profitable opportunities, and it is important to take them confidently. We can take them confidently because we are aligning industry strength or weakness, technical strength or weakness, as well as fundamental strength or weakness together using Q 360 degrees analysis. That is all that I plan to share in today's session. Thanks to all of you for joining. I look forward to seeing all of you in our next session. Have a great weekend, and as always, trade profitably.